Shalom! Welcome back, everybody. It's Parsha Shavuot time. I'm Levi Chazan, coming to you from Yerushalayim, Yeshivat Reon HaYehudi. Parsha Shavuot this week is Parsha Yitro. Parsha opens up and teaches us, Vayishma Yitro. Jethro heard. What exactly did Jethro hear? Well, Rashi informs us in other commentaries that actually he heard about the miracles which took place down in old Egypt land. The 10 plagues, the destruction of the mighty Egyptian army, the Red Sea splitting, all of this Jethro was well aware of and heard. Now it's interesting to note that the Midrash informs us that not only did the Red Sea split, but every body of water in the entire world split. That means if a person was kicking back and enjoying a nice bubble bath, that split right in half. If a guy was drinking a nice cup of tea, there you go, split right in half. So everybody was aware of the miracles that was taking place in old Egypt land. In fact, obviously, you have to realize this is pre-Facebook time. So the messages obviously didn't get out there in the zip-zaps split of a second. But obviously, it took a little bit long. But still, people were aware, and the Torah comes to teach us, Vayishma Yitro. Yitro heard about these great miracles that occurred. Now, it's interesting. Yitro came to the conclusion upon hearing about these great events, these miracles that took place, recognizing that there is one God in this world, because as we remember, Yitro is Kohen Midyan. He is the priest of idol worship. But now he comes to the realization that everything that he has done in his life has been false. Now he comes to the realization that there is one God in this world, the God of the Jewish people who had led them out of Egypt, split the sea for them, and brought them to Mount Sinai. So he comes to the realization and the conclusion, hey, I want to join these people. This is the truth. And the truth, you have to act upon it once you see it. You don't hide it. You don't close it up in a cupboard and say, you know, put it away for some other time. But once you see that the truth is out there, you act upon it. So Jethro came and he spent some time with the Jewish people. And then he goes back home to Midian, where he converts his family and some of his town people, and they all head up to the Holy Land to settle with the Jewish people. They all convert and they all become Ger Tzedek, part of the Jewish people, because he saw the truth and he acted upon it. Unfortunately, though, we know not everyone who sees the truth in this world acts upon it in a positive way. For instance, the Torah also tells us that it wasn't only Jethro that heard. Obviously, the entire world knew about it. We also know we're familiar with Amalek, the arch enemy of the Jewish people. They also heard. They also saw the great miracles. But they acted in a totally different way. What did they do? They came to attack and to try to destroy the Jewish people. This is the truth that they heard of over here. So they saw what was going on. They saw the truth in this world. But they acted upon it in a totally different way. They came to fight against the Jewish people. In fact, the Midrash teaches us that at the end of days, when the Messiah will be revealed, that a Messiah is coming to fix the entire world. He's trying to bring the redemption for the benefit of all mankind. And the nations of the world, the leaders will gather themselves together. They'll see that this guy is just incredible. And then they will all take counsel how to kill this guy. Unbelievable that it is. But when people face the truth, not everyone is up to the task of actually living it and going through the whole system. The few people who do, people like Jethro, they are the small individual, the minorities, who see the truth, recognize it, and come join that track of truth. The other people of the world, the great majority, either they're just out to lunch and they just don't see anything, or they're like the people who recognize the truth also, but they come to combat it, they come to fight against it, like the people of Amalek. It's not an easy task, obviously. Because we also see that amongst the Jewish people, even they actually partook of the miracles that happened to them. They went through the 10 plagues. They saw the mighty hand of God. They saw the splitting of the sea. And in fact, in spite of that, as soon as everything was passed and the Jewish people had to move on into the desert, after 3 days, they were thirsty and they complained. They complained to Moses, "Where is water?" A little bit later on, "Where is the food? We have no bread left." And it's not so bad that they didn't have a valid request. Of course they did. They were entitled to water. Of course, you can't live without water. But their tone was wrong. Their complaint was wrong. They should have believed in the Almighty that he could bring down food, and he could also supply with them with ample water. Because after all they saw, after everything they saw and been through, they saw the truth. Then there's nothing to worry about. And still, in spite of that, they weren't up to the cause. This is what we see over here, my dear beloved brothers and sisters. This is the task at hand. The truth set you free. You got to be up to it. It's only the small individuals, obviously, unfortunately, in this world, who are able to come up, the people like Jethro. Everyone else knew the truth, but wanted to come and fight against it. How silly that is. In any case, that's this lesson for this week, Jethro. I'm glad you could spend some time with us over here. I'm Levi Chazan. I'm coming to you from Yerushalayim. Till next time.